Herzog and the love interest of Panganuro. Panganuron as Charles, the love interest of Daragang Magayon and a Tagalog warrior. Pagtuga as Christian, a great but arrogant hunter and chieftain from Iraga who aims to win Daragang Magayon's heart. Raha Makusog as Jessa, the chief of the village of Ibalon and the loving father of Daragang Magayon. Ninog as Hannah, Pagtuga's henchman, the one who struck dead Panganuro. In the olden days, there lived a lovely maiden named Daragang Magayon in the Nayan of Ibalon. She was the daughter of Raha Makusog of Ibalon and the Wani, who died shortly after Magayon's birth. Had passed. Daragang Magayon's beauty attracted many suitors from different tribes. Among them was the haughty Pagtuga, the great hunter and powerful chieftain from Iraga, who courted her by lavishing her father fabulous gifts. But Daragang Magayon did not love Pagtuga. She had given her heart to Panganuron, the brave son of Raha Karilaya of the far-off Tagalog region. He had saved her from death in the river one morning. She had gone to bath in the Yawa River, which was swollen after a night of heavy rain. Balancing herself on a stone, she slipped and fell into the water. She did not know how to swim, and she would have been carried away by the swift current had Panganuron not come to her rescue. He happened to be passing by, and when he heard the maiden's frantic cry for help, he flung into the river. In an instant, he was at her side. Then he tenderly carried the frightened girl to dry land. Not long after, he spoke to her of his love. Daragang Magayon shyly admitted that she had also fallen in love with him. This gave the youth courage to thrust his spear at the foot of the stairs at Raha Makusog's house. Realizing that his daughter loved the young man and wishing only happiness for her, Makusog gave the couple his blessing with great joy. So, Panganuron left for home to prepare for the wedding. The news of the approaching wedding reached Pagtuga's ears in no time. He was very angry and he thought of a way to prevent the marriage. One day, when Raha Makusog went to the mountains to hunt, Pagtuga waylaid him and took him captive.
I will set you free, only if you give Magayon for a wife.
The answer is not mine to give, ask Magayon herself.
And so Daragang Magayon was brought before Pagtuga, told that Makusog would be put to death if she refused to be Pagtuga's bride. She tearfully consented to marry him.
We shall be married in 7 days.
And he ordered his people to prepare for a wedding. Learning of the sudden turn of events, Panganuron abandoned his own wedding preparations and hastily returned to Ibalon with his brave warriors.
But while Magayon was rushing joyously to meet her beloved, a stray arrow caught her at the back. As Panganuron held the dying maiden in his arms, he was struck dead by a spear hurled by Linog, Pagtuga's henchman. Seeing this, makusog rush at linog and killed him with his minasbad. That would have been a joyful occasion became a day of mourning. As the people buried their dead, Raha Makusog himself dug the grave where he tenderly laid the bodies of the lovers. Days after, the people saw the grave rise as it grew higher, eventually assuming the form of a pearly cone. It was attended by muffled rumblings and quakes. On certain days, when the tip of the volcano is shrouded in mist and cloud, the old folks say that Panganurun is kissing Magayon. When afterwards rain trickles down to mountain slopes, they say that the raindrops are Panganurun tears as he cries over his lost love.
Hanggang maubos ang